the first time we are trying to take some initiative to develop a movement of the IT and ITES employees across the country. The IT employees, they are generally, there is a feeling, there is an impression that are highly paid and they are not workers, etc. But the actual, this thing, as far as CITU is concerned, we believe, and it's a fact, that wherever there is an employer and an employee, one who is paying somebody wages and getting the work done, so that is a worker or employee. And all the laws should be implemented for them as the country has. So, but actually IT employees, some of them may be getting better wages, but and the working conditions means the ambience at the workplace may be also good, but actually they are working under a lot of pressure, and the profits that are generated through their work is most of it, around 75-80% of it, the wealth generated by the their work is garnered by the employers, including the foreign companies. So they are also exploited, and particularly the ITS employees. Both the IT employees and ITS employees, they don't have any job security, they don't have any working hours, they don't have even the, in the true sense, the ITS employees' minimum wages, some 10,000, 15,000, even 5,000-6,000 are paid to them in ITS in many places, and no social security benefits are implemented for them, provident fund, ESI, etc. And their number is in lakhs. So we want that they should be organized, but till a few years back, the IT employees also had an impression that they are not workers, they are not employees, they are professionals. So they were not ready to address collectively their problems.
Started being felt, and a ground is prepared that they have to be brought to the organized movement of the workers. Without that, those who are producing the wealth, giving the service, their interest can never know anything protected. That was the lessons of the history. Unless you organize, you may be able to fighting, you may be able to protect some of your rights and some of your interests. And if you don't organize, you will be gradually converted to a slave. In fact, the working class movement is a movement, conscious movement, of fighting against imposition of the conditions of slavery. Highest return on capital is ensured on this sector, even in the crisis of present day crisis of capitalism. Even Government of India admitted at one point of time, and it was published in the economic survey, that every $2 value created in ITES sector, $1.51 goes back to the place of origin where from the job was outsourced in the ITES sector. We are yet to bring the particular serious extraction of sweat and blood, the life force of the ITES, IT and ITES employee in the national agenda.
We are here in the National Convention of IT Employees. The thing is, the employees throughout IT industry are under pressure. I mean, there is a thing is, fourth industrial revolution is taking place now in industry. Companies are thinking about the company's growth and the industry growth, but they are not thinking about the workers or about how employees will be exploited. For example, we can see in ITES. India is the largest IT-enabled service provider. So here, the new technologies like artificial intelligence, machine learning are going to replace the workers with telebots or chatbots, things like that. So the employees will be replaced to some machines or some technologies. So thing here is, we are not opposed to technology, but the industry should consider the employee situation also, and they should reskill the employees.
From 1991, CITU has been fighting against whatever is called flexibility of labor. Flexibility of the labor is what employers are propagating. And it is the IT companies who are in the leadership of this campaign against labor laws. We should know that. We always see our own employers, immediate employer only, as our enemy. Immediate employer is our enemy, but we should know that it is the capitalist class which is our enemy. That this convention must be made use for us not only to lead the IT segment, being the IT itself is the deciding factor of technology in all industries, including motor industries. We should be able to lead the working class.
We have been trying since last 10 years. Now it has taken a shape. At least in 4-5 centers, registered entity could be established. Within them, we are making a national coordination committee with a goal to spread some 7, 8, 9, 10 sectors getting a registered entity more, draw them in the coordination committee and go for a national federation.
That the NASCOM was formed 30 years ago and we are having our first national convention now. The leading role of the working class in the hegemony of this country, there we are having a big role to lead. Now the information available is only by the NASCOM or people like TPs or something. So we have to make the country aware of what is happening in the new technologies, what is the new forms of exploitation in our sector and all. So for that also, we have to work very hard and you have to take the lead in that. And I am confident and I have confidence and I would like to be taking up your struggles to take it further and also be the leaders of the trade union movement and working class movement of India.
Worker unity Zindabad.
Worker unity Zindabad.
Up, up socialism.
Up, up socialism.
Down, down capitalism.
Down, down capitalism.
Up, up socialism.
Up, up socialism.
Down, down capitalism.
Down, down.